An icon of the desert, the saguaro cactus, is being threatened by drought conditions and rising temperatures. Our reporter Stephanie Tsai ventured into the Sonoran Desert to see what those trends mean for ecosystems across the Southwest.
On the edge of Saguaro National Park in Tucson, Arizona, Maria Francisco and Tanisha Tucker uphold a sacred tradition of the Thano Atham tribe, harvesting fruit from the majestic saguaro, the largest cactus in the U.S. Using an old saguaro rib as a gathering tool, they have only a few weeks each summer to do the picking before southern Arizona's monsoon season spoils the fruit.
The fruit that we cook and turn into syrup becomes wine, and that wine is then used for rain ceremonies.
The sacred tradition has remained the same, but the saguaros themselves are changing. For Francisco, the first sign of this is the late ripening of the fruit.
When I used to come out here with my Aunt Stella, I would be out here like mid-May, and she'd be out here mid-May. Now it's like mid-June.
What we're concerned about is that we're seeing far fewer very small saguaros.
In Saguaro National Park, which is brimming with the plants, biologist Don Swan says prolonged drought conditions and higher temperatures are increasing the mortality rate of young saguaros.
The older they are, the more resilient they become to deeper and deeper droughts, right? So they're very resilient when they're, you know, 60 years old, but they're not very resilient when they're 5 years old.
A 2018 National Park report showed that of the 10,000 saguaros studied within the park, just 70 were less than 15 years old.
We're trying to understand how changes in temperature and precipitation in the future might affect the reproductive potential of saguaros. You know, everything from how old they are when they start reproducing to how many flowers do they produce.
To do this, they fix a GoPro camera to what amounts to a very tall selfie stick. In spring and summer, they regularly take pictures of the flowers that bloom on the tops of saguaro arms. When compared over time, the pictures document changes to the saguaro life cycle. The plant's flowers, which when pollinated produce the fruit, can give scientists key information about long-term impacts of climate change. But to Swan, the saguaros are about more than science.
For me, what's so wonderful about saguaros is really kind of the way that they move people. And a lot of people who live here will tell you that one of the reasons they live here is because of this plant.
Rising temperatures and drought aren't the only threats to the saguaros. Invasive grass species like this compete for water and also increase fire risk.
We have this increase of non-native grasses, the grassification of the western United States and in many of the deserts. And that drives a fire regime and introduces a fire regime to the deserts that's pretty novel.
And you can see the burn marks on that one.
Ben Wilder is an ecologist studying the long-term impact of fire damage on the Sonoran Desert ecosystem. Remnants of the 2020 Bighorn Fire can still be found in the Santa Catalina Mountains on Tucson's perimeter. Thousands of saguaros were killed in the blaze.
It's eye-opening in terms of what is the desert's capacity for resilience in the face of fire. And that's truly an open question right now.
The saguaro isn't the only Western species under threat from the wildfires being fueled by climate change. Within the Mojave National Preserve in California, an estimated 1.3 million Joshua trees were killed in a 2020 wildfire. That same year, wildfires killed approximately 10% of the world's giant sequoia trees. Last year, another 5% were lost to additional wildfires in the state.
Coming to grips with the massive loss that is happening is part of the ecological change that we're all within.
To counter the loss, the Tucson Audubon Society is planting young saguaros, positioning them near so-called nurse plants, which act as shade and shields. Jonathan Horst says saguaros are a keystone species.
We've got 14 species of birds, multiple species of bats, hundreds of species of insects, rodents, javelina, foxes, everything is chowing down on the fruits when they drop. Without saguaros, in a lot of ways, giant pieces of the Sonoran Desert ecosystem just implode.
Soon, thousands of these saguaros will be planted in southern Arizona's Santa Catalina Mountains as part of a larger restoration effort.
Those first 2 years, that's the most critical establishment phase. Then the survival rate significantly increases.
These imposing desert plants, armored with spikes, suddenly seem vulnerable. And to Tanisha Tucker and Maria Francisco, it's like watching a relative suffer.
We have a relationship with them. So in our creation stories, we mention them and we talk about them as being people and elders.
But they also talk about them as nature's survivors, whom they revere. After scraping the fruit out and savoring its sweetness, the empty pods are solemnly returned to the giver.
As a Native American, we're very resilient people. We always bounce back. And that's how I see these saguaros. You know, they're going to adjust to climate change.
Who and what can adjust is the biggest question facing not only the Sonoran Desert, but the whole planet. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Stephanie Tsai in Tucson, Arizona.